Remove the four screws from the control panel using an 1/8-inch hex wrench. Then, remove the control panel. Next, remove the ground wire screw from the housing using a 7/32-inch hex wrench. Disconnect the control panel by removing the two magnet connectors, safety switch connector, pilot light connector, and the black and white motor wires. Cut the wire tie if present. Disconnect all the wire connections from the control panel to the circuit board. The red wire connection, the black wire connection, the red, black, and white connection. Finally, disconnect the 6 wires running to the magnet switch, the blue and brown wires, and the 2 sets of black and white wires. With all the connections unplugged, we can now remove the circuit board. Simply remove the 3 Phillips screws. And slide the circuit board off. Run the black, white, and green power cord wires through the center hole of the circuit board. Attach the circuit board to the control panel with the 3 Phillips screws. Let's connect the circuit board to the control panel using the following connections. Connect the 6 wires to the magnet switch. First, the blue and brown wires. Next, the large black and white power cord wires, which run through the center of the circuit board. And finally, the middle black and white wires. Then, the red wire connection, black wire connection, and finally, the red, black, and white connection. Oh. Attach the ground wire to the housing. Plug in the black and white motor wires. Then, attach the pilot light connector, safety switch connector, and two magnet connectors. Reinstall the control panel into the housing using the four screws. Your drill is now ready to use.